Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to demonstrate how to implement object level security in Salesforce. Before starting, if you want to watch more Salesforce training videos, you can go to description of this video and you can find links of various playlists related to Salesforce. So now I am starting my demonstration for object level security. So we can control object level permissions for both standard and custom objects. You can set permission for a particular object. You can give permission to view, create, edit, and delete any record of that object. And these permissions can be controlled using profiles and permission sets. So let me take you to the org. So here you can see various users are listed. So currently I'm logged in with this, my system admin user, that is Sanjay Gupta. And I'm going to do modifications for the profile which is related to the user Vikas Gupta, and name of profile is my user profile, and this is a custom profile. So I'm searching for that profile. So here it is. I'm opening this profile, and if I scroll down, so you will see object level permissions where we can set. So this is for standard object permissions. So here you can see read, create, edit, and delete permission we can give. And for administration purpose, we can set view all and modify all. And these are custom objects which are available in this org. So we can set these as well. So now I am going to another browser where I am going to log in with Vikas Gupta. So now I'm going to edit these permissions so that you can see the changes. So let me do this for account object. So here you can see we can create new accounts. If I go to existing account, we have edit and delete permission, and we can view the details as well, right? Now I'm going to modify these things for account only. So I'm going to remove edit and delete permissions. So this way user can view any account, or user can create an account. A user cannot edit and delete account records, right? So this way I remove these permissions for this profile user, and I'm going to save this profile. So whatever number of users are associated with this profile, changes will be applicable for all the users. Now let me refresh this. So here you can see edit and delete options are gone. And if I try to change this, so here you can see entity type cannot be updated. So we are not able to edit this record. And since delete option is not available, so we cannot delete this record. So this way, through profile, I controlled access of a particular record for a particular object. So this change applied on account object only. And if we go to contact, so contact has all the permissions. So if I move to contact, so in contact record, you will see all the permissions will be there. So here new button is available. If I open any other, if I open any contact, so you can see edit and delete options are available. So we can edit this record. So this way you can set permission for a specific object and for specific permission, whether it is read, create, edit, or delete, right? Now what happens, let's say five users are associated with this profile, and you want a particular user can edit and delete account records. So to do that, you can create permission sets. So to open up permissions, you can create permission sets, and you can assign that permission set to a particular user so that that particular permission can be assigned to a user. So you can click on new. So demo permission set. So here you can set license as well. So I'm right now applying none and saving this. So here it is. So in this object setting, I can give additional permission. So I'm opening accounts. So here you can see right now no permission is available. So remember one thing, permission sets only plus the permission. So if I'm clicking on edit and delete, so it means I am adding these permissions. So you cannot revoke permissions with the help of permission set. So whatever permissions are available on profile, they will be as it is. But through permission sets, you can add on additional permissions for particular user. So I'm clicking on save. So this way I created this permission set and I gave object level permissions. Now if I want to assign this permission set to a particular user, so I'm clicking on manage users. From here I can add assignment. I am choosing this user and clicking on assign. So Vikas Gupta, for this permission set is assigned to Vikas Gupta. Now this user will be, only this user related to this profile will be able to edit and delete account record as well. So if I do a refresh, now I'm moving to accounts, clicking on a particular account, and here you can see edit and delete permissions are available now. So this way, I hope you understood how we can manage object level permissions with the help of profiles and permission sets in Salesforce. So you can set, view, create, edit and delete permission for a particular object so that they can be applied on records for particular users. And you can control these with the help of profiles and permission sets. So remember, if you give some permission on profile, so those will be applicable for all users. Those are associated with that profile. And if you want to give additional permissions, then you can create permission sets and you can assign those permission sets to specific users. So they will be having additional permissions so that you can control object level security for users. So I hope you understood all about object level security and also enjoyed the demonstration. So you can apply this in your org so that you can practice it and you can understand like how object level security works in Salesforce. If you want to watch field level security, record level security, org level security, so playlist link that is data security in Salesforce is available in the description of this video. You can open and you can watch all related videos. Thank you for watching this video.